marking out the joint on the rail, or the bridle joint section, we need to come back 40 mil from the end of the job. So I mark 40 and I square that line. The width of the joint is the thickness of my timber. So I line my timber up with my pencil line, put a little mark on the opposite side. I still use my tri-square to square that. And then I want to square these lines all the way around my piece of timber, because I need to have my joints on both sides. And now I need to mark out how deep they're going to be. Now, on our leg, that space was 10 mil. This is 19 mil thick, and I want to have an even amount out of both sides. If I need to leave 10 mil in the bottom, 10 from 19 is 9. I need to half that, so each joint here needs to be roughly 4.5 mil deep. Now I could either just use the ruler and mark that out. Wouldn't be quite as accurate, and I'd have to do it multiple times. So I'm going to get a marking gauge to mark that section out. Before I do, for this little shaping here, it's telling me that I need to be 20 mil from the top edge, 20 mil from the corner, and then I just join those up. And I'm going to get rid of this little piece for the decoration at the end of the rail. Now, forgetting the depth of my bridle joint sections on here, I'm using a marking gauge. Now I want to get this distance to 4.5. The idea is that you get it close to it, check it with the gauge, and I'm a little bit over. Just a little bit over, I'm probably just a little bit over 5 mil, so light tap. You can just see there, I'm now at roughly about 4.5 mil. Keeping the stock of the marking gauge leaning flat on my timber, tilt it down until the spur is just touching between my lines, and drag that between my lines. You can just see the line, I'll put a little pencil mark into it. That's my 4.5 down. Now, because I've got my marking gauge set, I can go ahead and mark that on there as well. So you can see that I've got my roughly 10 mil space here to meet up with my section out of the top of the leg. And I'll mark these out on the bottom of my rail as well. So this is the section that I'm going to be getting rid of, leaving this little part as part of the bridle joint in the middle. You also repeat that on the opposite end of your rail, so you've got similar joints and shaping on both sides of the rail.